Have you gone down a YouTube rabbit hole?
Oh my gosh. Like at work.
Right. Well, that's where
it happens.
That's exactly where it belongs, I think.
And I'm pretty sure my coworkers used to peek into my office and be like, "Is she watching another gymnastics video?" Whatever.
You had an office?
Yes, I did have an office. I know.
A long Congratulations.
Time ago. Thank you.
It's with
you.
A door and everything.
It had a window. I know.
Oh my goodness.
I know.
Were you watching? Do they have old videos?
Oh my gosh, I'm so glad you asked.
Oh, thank you.
Yes. And I'm obsessed. I am obsessed with old gymnastics videos.
Okay.
Let's see. Like the 1950s gymnastics videos are a little silly.
Okay. Why?
Just in what would win you an Olympic gold medal at that time.
Oh, right. Because the skill level was so much.
The skill level is like, and it just. It's kind of shocking to see what was considered women's gymnastics. We're talking about women who were in their mid-30s would often win. And one was pregnant, like when she was, early pregnancy.
Right,
she
didn't,
like, have a bump or anything.
And so her water broke, and it really got her a 10.
That didn't happen.
Got her a 10.
So sympathy 10,
What was the routine in the 50s that was so...
So it's, and talking about going down the rabbit hole of like YouTube videos, then you have to read the comments. I mean, that's a big part of it because you'll read and almost every single video is the same. Just like these routines are so easy. And then the next person, always somebody weighs in and was like, but the equipment was so different. Like the floor was like a hard floor.
Oh, it was just a hard, like gym floor?
Like a hard, yeah. I mean, they would put like a mat down.
Sure.
But in terms, like no springs, like no like real padding or anything.
Are there springs and padding now?
Yes. Yeah. Which is how they get so high.
I was wondering about the bounciness. Yeah. I thought that there's was a like, lot they must of, have yeah. so much leg power. Not that they don't.